I started having stomach problems when I was about 6 years old. As I got older, I had numerous surgeries for intestinal blockage. One morning, I just kept throwing up. Took myself to the emergency room. The last thing I remember was going through the operating room, September 24th, 2014, and waking up here at Duke, October 5th.
His local physicians had really felt like there were no opportunities to save his life. They had tried to operate on him. He had a lot of adhesions from all of his prior surgery, and they had eventually had to just abandon the surgery and left his abdomen open. But they had heard of Duke and our intestinal failure program and offered the family, if you want to try going there, you know, this could be an option.
I guess we tried different procedures. 21 surgeries about 21 surgeries, and I think the transplant was like the last resort.
It's a fairly rare sort of transplant. Not very many have been done. Approximately 2,000 in the United States and about 3,000 worldwide, or a little less. Patients who need an intestine or a bowel transplant are patients who don't have the ability to eat or absorb nutrients from their intestine.
I was put on the transplant list for a small bowel transplant and abdominal wall transplant.
Because he had had so many prior procedures, we worried a lot about how we were going to get a graft in and have coverage. We really started talking more about abdominal wall transplant.
This technique really opens the doors to any future patients who might have a similar problem, an abdominal wall that is injured from previous surgeries and an organ or a small bowel that these patients require.
I mean, Dr. Sudan, she explained everything in detail what was going to happen. It was going to be, you know, up and down every day.
And it can feel like you're running a marathon to take, you know, 50 steps down the hall.
There will be some days when you will feel down, but you got to look at that finish line, like you're almost there. I just can't express how. Just to be under their care, man, it was... I mean, not only did they talk to me, not only did they show me they care, they assured my family that I was in good hands, I was in good care.
All right, in the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Thank you for watching over my family, watching over everybody as I was in the hospital. Thank you for letting me be here, just cooking, just doing the natural things that we do together.
When we get the donor organ offers and can bring them in and do the surgeries to replace the organs that are failed, and they recover and go home and get back to normal life, it is just fantastic.
This is mind-blowing to me. I would have never thought this was possible. You know, I know Duke is all about Duke basketball, you know, but this is, I'd rather be on this starting team.